Something is wrong today, or weird. Oh, I think we're back. We're back to regular gravity, right? Yes, it worked. Awesome. Let's put this away. Ah. Now, we are the 9th of December, so it's day number 9 of our 24 days of random awesomeness. And as you have seen already yesterday, this box we have today is a little bit big to put inside of a bag, so I just put the bag on top of it and we remove this right now before it catches fire. And we have a flight case. Now, what is it? Well, you know what a green screen is, I suppose. Probably most people know what a green screen is nowadays, because it's a technology that came out in the early 1900s already. It's basically a green backdrop or blue. It can be white or black even. And you light it very evenly, and then you set somebody in front of it and you film him, and you can later on replace the green with any sort of content, pictures, drawings, whatever you like. Now, that's used a lot, even nowadays, where they use a lot of other technologies like retro projections or LED walls to do kind of the same thing. But it's still, used quite often. And when you are out in the field for a news gathering, for example, sometimes they want you to make a green screen setup. And of course, that would mean you need the whole rig. You need like the green screen with the tripods, you need some light sources, you need, the camera gear and all that stuff. And depending on where you are, that can be very annoying. So we bought this system years back, and it's been on the shelf for a long, long time now, because it has been replaced with other things. But I find it very interesting. So let's open this up and I will show you what this basically is, because all you need to make a green screen outdoors, outdoors or indoors, somewhere in the world, is this box here. Let's open this up. And you see you have some stuff in here. This is even not, this is a battery charger. You don't even need this. You can reduce the size of this box even. You know what? I will put this next to me because we won't have any space at all to show anything. Let's put this down here. All right, and let's start off with the first item out of that box, which is this little controller here. And you see you have a knob here for green and blue. You have a dimmer potentiometer. You have some connections here. Power, main power on and off. The LED ring that we come to in a second. GPI, I think, is some sort of a remote control. I can't remember. And there is a remote control actually. So, you can remote control this somehow, one way or the other. That's this little thing. The whole system is not too complex. It's basically all very simply made, but I find the idea very, very cool. And of course you have a power supply. We usually run this off battery simply because most of the time when you're in the field, AC power is pretty rare. You have some adapter rings to put on your lens. So that's that. And then we have this. And all the stuff is like, when this technology came out, it was kind of brand new, so that's why they came up with it that late, probably, because you see this is an LED ring, and in that time, like, super bright LEDs were something very new. So, you see what this does. This comes on your camera, there's a little set screw, you can put this in place on your lens. And you have two rings of LEDs here. I can tell you one is blue, one is green. And let's put this on just to give you a look how this works. Of course, you plug in your power. It was already turned on. You plug in your LED ring. By the way, this is pretty cool. But I like them. This is a mini XLR plug. And you have this knob here. And it's pretty cool because when you put this in, you know, it clicks in place and you won't be able to pull it out that easily. And it's way smaller than regular XLR. Now, we have this and that. Let's put this on. You turn it on here and you see you have a green LED ring. You can dim it down, you can put it up, and you can simply switch to blue. No, you couldn't. Well, that's probably because, yes, because I had the remote switch to remote and not to the local controls. Now we have blue and green, which is pretty cool. But now you would ask, well, what does it do? Because now when I hold this in place, well, when I dim it down, everything becomes a little bluish, but that's about it. Now, even on a white surface, this would not work very well. But that's why we are coming now to the main part of this system, and I think also the most interesting thing about this system, which basically is this special backdrop. And you see it's a gray thing, a gray backdrop that you can hold in place using some clamps. Like, I think they're in the box as well. Of course they are. So you have, like, you know, these tripod things, so you can clamp this there in place, or you just simply use these and make this hold somewhere on the shelf or wherever. And what does this backdrop do? Well, this backdrop basically has the same principle than a road sign, a street sign. And if you see, I don't know if you can see this, and I don't want to light it on fire, but I try to hold this further up to the camera. You see there are millions of very little, tiny little dots. And these dots are basically the same principle, as I said, as a street sign, so they are reflecting. So, when I take this and I turn this around and I light this up, you see not much happens. It is kind of, well, it is kind of blue. But when I bring this into the angle of the lens, let's try this. Let's put this here, and I have to hold this for now, but you see how nicely even blue this thing gets. And I'm it's not that easy to hold this in place while showing it, but you could adjust the brightness in a way that only the backdrop is blue and not your hand, for example, as in this case, because now it looks terrible. But when you have a little bit of space behind it, or in between the actor and this thing, and especially when there's not too much light falling onto this, you can achieve a very nice blue screen or green screen effect. And the nice thing is this gets lit very evenly without having any external light sources. So you really only need like your two or three light sources for your presenter, and don't bother too much about the backdrop, because the backdrop will be lit by this little LED ring. And this works even on the outdoors. We tried this on daylight and it works. Works pretty well even. And you see, well, it's hard to show because, as I said, it is very bright here on my bench. So you see that when I light this on here, you don't see too much, but when I put this in the axis of the camera, it glows bluish. And this works in a very wide angle as well. So when I tilt this, you see that it doesn't matter in what perspective you are filming this backdrop, it will reflect the blue light from almost every angle, as long as your LED ring is in the same axis than your camera lens. So I fixed the ring to the lens. I don't know if this works better now, but yeah, this is now adjusted to a point where I would say we could make a green key or blue key on this. But this would be mounted on the backdrop or on the background, and you had like the actor or the presenter standing a couple of feet in front of it. So here everything is very close together. So, you know, you see all the shadows and stuff going on. Basically on this bench, as we have pretty even lighting, it would be easier to use a real green screen or a piece of blue cardboard instead of this. But you see the principle, how it works. And I really like this little thing, this little gadget. I think it's a really cool piece of technology. And you see also you can play around with it. You see now everything becomes blue, and probably the key will look terrible. And I would say that somewhere around this should give us a pretty nice chroma key on that bench. All right, that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed. Let's have a short peek of tomorrow's bag, which is this one. And you hear it, it sounds plasticky. It's a mid-sized bag, very lightweight. Could be maybe some toys, I don't know. We'll see, tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed and have a nice evening, and I see you tomorrow. Until then, see ya.